Hi, my name is Sinisha, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to use our biggest new feature in Spine 4.0, the new graph view. The graph view has been completely redone to show values across the entire animation. This is very powerful and makes it easier to create great animations. Let's open the new graph view. You can find it by clicking Views in the upper right corner of Spine, or by pressing Alt-G. The graph view provides a different perspective of the same data shown in the dope sheet. Like the dope sheet, it uses your viewport selection, has filter, lock, refresh, select, and clipboard buttons, and functions like shift and offset. Rows are shown for each kid property, grouped by bone. Each row has a visibility dot to set which curves are shown in the graph. Right-click or hold Ctrl when left-clicking a visibility dot to set multiple visibility dots at the same time. The graph view can be zoomed with the mouse wheel and hotkeys, just like the viewport. To adjust the zoom of the axis separately, hold Alt and drag with the right mouse button. We can also frame our curve or frame a part of it by selecting the desired keys and pressing the frame button. When auto is enabled, the graph view will automatically zoom to keep all the curves visible. Let's explore the graph view functionality and then we'll use it to animate a simple bouncing ball. I'm going to turn on auto key. You may notice we moved the auto key button to the toolbar, so you can now access it without having the dope sheet open. The horizontal axis of the graph view represents time, measured in frames, and the vertical axis represents the value. The unit for the value axis depends on the type of curve. Keys in the graph are shown as little squares. As the curve travels across the graph view from left to right, it shows us the value of the X translation as it moves forward in time. The access buttons allow moving keys to be restricted to only up and down or left to right. Of course, you can also set up hotkeys for all of the graph's functions. Some timelines key multiple values. For example, a translate timeline keys both X and Y together, even though they each get their own curve. If a key is moved left-right on either curve, it will also move for the other curve. We can easily separate the curves by selecting the bone, going to the tree view, and checking separate translate. Now the X and Y keys can be moved independently. Selected keys and handles can be moved by dragging. When Drag to Edit is enabled, you can drag in empty space to make adjustments. Like in the dope sheet, to duplicate the selected keys, hold Ctrl-Shift when starting the drag. To disable frame snapping, hold Shift. And to delete the key, double-click it or press Delete. The Sync button synchronizes the dope sheet with the graph, so the dope sheet will show only the rows for the curves that the graph is showing. Also, if the dope sheet is above or below the graph, the dope sheet zoom will match the graph view zoom so the keys align vertically. Let's set up some keys. First, for the up and down movements, I will key the Y translation at the lowest and highest poses. For the left to right movement, I only need two keys, the start and stop poses. Spine has three types of curves: stepped, linear, and Bezier. Setting the curve type for a key affects the transition between that key and the next key. Let's set the key to Bezier and look at the handles that appear. The handles allow you to control the shape of the curve between keys. You could achieve the same using many linear keys, but a Bezier key is easier to control and using fewer keys is better. To adjust only the length, hold Shift. To adjust the length of both handles at the same time, hold Ctrl Shift. Here we have a number of buttons to help you position the Bezier handles. These buttons will also set the curve type to Bezier if it's not already set. When a handle is set to automatic, it shows as a triangle and the handle is positioned automatically. Moving the handle turns it back into a normal handle. Automatic handles often provide good results. It can be useful to first apply automatic handles and then only adjust them manually if necessary. Normally, moving a handle affects the handle on the other side, ensuring the transition through the key is smooth. To move a handle without affecting the other side, press the separate button or press Alt while dragging. The flat button moves the handles so they align vertically with the key. Bounce separates the handles and places them toward the previous and next keys. This is helpful for our bouncing ball animation, so I will use it as a starting point and then tweak the curves afterwards. Is out moves the handles so the value changes more slowly near the key. Is in moves the handles so the value changes more slowly near the next key. It's also easy to scale the keys. The box selection disappears when made quickly. To make it stay, pause briefly before releasing the mouse button. The edges of the box selection can be scaled left-right to change the timing or up-down to change the value. When a key is moved vertically or horizontally, it snaps to its original position, shown by a white line. This allows changing a key's value without accidentally changing its frame, or its frame without changing its value. To snap a key to other keys, press the Snap button or hold Alt Shift. This can help when a key needs to have the same value as another key. If you hover a specific key briefly, snapping will prefer that key. The Graph's Favor tool is used with the pose-to-pose workflow. Show the Favor slider by clicking the Favor button. The slider helps you to create breakdown poses by setting keys that are more like the previous keys or the next keys. To use the Favor slider, position the timeline between two keys and drag the slider. I will create a simple animation of a ball moving from left to right to show how the Favor tool works. Dragging it to the left creates a key more like the key before the current frame. Dragging it to the right creates a key more like the key after the current frame. If you move the slider past the end of the slider, you will go past the previous or next key values. Hotkeys can be used to make using the Favor slider faster. Check out our Spine workflow tutorial video for more details about using the Favor tool. The next feature is the Store button. Often, you need to do some experimentation when polishing your curves and the store button is a great way to try things without worrying about losing your animation. For example, let's say I like the animation I made, but I wanted to have fewer keys for performance requirements or just to make it easier to modify the animation. Press the store button, delete the keys on frame 5 and 25. You can see the stored curve drawn dimly in the back. Now I will try to match the stored curve using fewer keys. Let's play the animation. As you can see, the result is very similar. But if you don't like it, you can click the swap button to store your current curve and return your stored curve. You can go back and forth to decide which you like more. The value and shape buttons control how Bezier handles are adjusted when keys are moved left, right. When neither is selected, the handles don't change as you move keys. When value is selected, the handles change so the curve keeps its minimum and maximum values. But its shape is not preserved. When shape is selected, the handles change so the curve keeps its shape, but the minimum and maximum curve values change. Depending on your animation, these buttons can reduce the work needed to fix up curves after you move keys to adjust timing. Lastly, it's important to mention that when a curve bends sharply or is very large, it may be possible to see the line segments that make up the curve. This is not a bug. The graph shows exactly how the curve is approximated at runtime. If a curve is not smooth enough, it is easily remedied by adding keys. This is a quick overview of the new graph in Spine. We hope you will enjoy it. Try it out and have fun! Happy animating!